Hi. Okay, bus. Hey guys, my name is Ayush Mehra. My age is 27. My height is 5'8", and here are my profiles. Other side. This is the only way I could start my TED talk because I've been doing this in auditions so much that I thought this is the best way I could start. So I always never want to be an actor, okay? I was actually of the thought that ye sab drama wama na, ye sab ladkiyon ke liye hota hai. Main sports mein hoon, main sports khelunga. But little did I know that I would end up doing this my entire life. It's not that I didn't like films, I really enjoyed watching films. I was a huge Shah Rukh Khan fan. I still am a huge Shah Rukh Khan fan. And I'll tell you how I became an actor. So, it started from me being a dancer. And for that, I have to thank my sister. Because I remember when I finished my 10th standard, she pestered me and she said, let's join Shamak Dawar dance classes. And I was like, I do not want to join Shamak Dawar dance classes. Yaar, meko sports khelna hai. And she said, ke yaar, main teko ek jersey aur shoes gift karungi. Sold. So, I was pretty cheap then also. And I joined the classes and I started joining the beginner batch. And after doing the show, to my surprise, I got a call back from SPB. Now, SPB is something which is called as a special potential batch in Shamak. It's for people who want to pursue dance as a career. So I was pretty skeptical at that point of time, yeah, dance, abhi. But I was like, chalo, let's do it. And I did it, and I did it for 2 years, 2.5 years. I started enjoying dancing, and I started doing shows with Shamak behind TV actors. Like, started dancing with dupatta lekar jo jata tha. I was that guy. Till a point where I thought, yeah, I want to dance in front. Not because the actor used to act and show, aisa kuch nahi hota tha. But it was just that I used to rehearse a song for 10 days, and the actor used to come in the last 2 days and still get the center. And I was like, yaar, I want to be that guy. So I thought, as a leap of faith lete, and let's quit dancing and go to acting. Worst come worst, kya hoga? I'll come back to dancing after 4 months. So I was like, okay, chal, let's do it. So now I want to tell you all about my first audition. So, I have no family, no friends, no friends of friends, no family of friends in this industry. So it was really difficult for me to find out ke yaar main kahan jaun auditions ke liye. So luckily I had a friend of mine in Shamak who was also an actor, and at that point of time nobody gave auditions aisa ke yaar yahan pe ho raha chale ja, because they used to think mere chances chale jayenge. But I annoyed him. I continuously annoyed him, pestered him and said yaar bhej dena ek ek ek, and he said yaar wahan ho raha hai chale ja. And I was like, bas, aa gaya dusra Shah Rukh Khan. I was ready. I was like, ye hole hai guske, ab to Bollywood ka star. So I remember on the day of the audition, I got ready. I was fully dressed and I thought, ek ghanta pehle pahunchta impression marunga, and I reach and I see the door is shut. And I was like, okay, ab kya karenge, wait kara. So I waited outside and the casting director was a little late. Obviously, at that point of time, Kavish just went, okay, don't tell him. the casting director was late, and by that time, you know, people started coming. A lot of people started coming. And it was an age group of a father and son. So there were more people. And slowly, tugging and this thing started to happen. A lot of bheed started to come. And I was like, arre bhi Shah Rukh Khan ko kaise touch kar raha hai yaar? So the casting director came. And we all went inside, and there were like 40 people inside, okay? And it was a sight. Everybody was late, everybody was just like, jaldi, 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 yaar, jaldi karo, next audition pe jana hai, ye karna hai, wo karna hai. And I'm listening to everybody, yeah, and the casting director is like, name, number, profile, though. And I had no clue ke kya hota hai wo, which I just gave right now, which shows that I've become a good actor. Thoda growth to hua hai. So, I gave my name, number, profile, and he told me, ke, I'll give you the brief, to tum aise acting kar lena. So I said, okay, okay. So the brief was that I'm talking about a corrupt business deal, or I'm talking about fleecing somebody, and someone just hits me from behind, and I'm like, abe, kaun hai be? And it's actually the newspaper. The newspaper ad tha. So aisa tha ke the newspaper is watching everything. I know. Okay. So uske baad, I did it. He said action. So I started, and obviously there were a lot of people talking. I was very conscious at that point of time. So I said, sorry, sorry, sorry. Apne aap hi. Cut. अपने आप ही बोल के सॉरी सॉरी बोल के रुक गया. देन द कास्टिंग डायरेक्टर सेड आई विल डू दिस, देन यू टर्न बैक. सो आई वॉज ओनली वेटिंग फॉर हिज दिस सो दैट आई कुड टर्न बैक एंड आई स्क्रूड अप अगेन. देन द थर्ड टाइम ऑल्सो समथिंग रॉन्ग हैपेंड एंड द फोर्थ टाइम ही टोल्ड मी स्टॉप, गेट अप, गेट आउट, एक्टिंग नहीं आती ना तो मत क्या करो. एग्जैक्टली. Pin drop silence in my head. People around me are laughing at me. Some of them are watching and some of them are saying ke yaar ha kaisa hai yaar pata nahi time waste kar dete hain. And I'm just looking at everyone and I walk out. I run. I reach my house. My mom opens the door for me and I run in my room and I remember going on my bed and starting crying. Like I cried. I cried. And my mom came up to me and said, kya hua beta, why are you crying? And I said, oh, casting director ne aise baat kar li. I went on and went on and went on. And then my mom told me, okay, if you don't want to act, don't act. But for me, just give 10 auditions. So I was like, yaar, nahi yaar, I don't want. She was like, okay, do it for me. Just 10 auditions. And I was like, yaar, shit. Kal se 10 auditions dekhe chhod dunga. नहीं करना मुझे ये. सो नेक्स्ट डे आई गेट अप. आई हैव एब्सोल्युटली नो आइडिया नाउ वेयर टू गो फॉर ऑडिशन बिकॉज दैट फ्रेंड वाज नॉट गोना हेल्प मी. तो आई जस्ट न्यू के आरामनगर और माड़ा पे ऑडिशंस होते हैं जहाँ पे बंगलोज भी सिक्वेंशली नंबर्ड नहीं है. लाइक इफ यू सी 126, 127, 188 आ जाएगा. हाफ ऑफ योर स्ट्रगल इज के यार बंगलो किधर है ऑडिशन देने के लिए. सो आई यूज टू बी आउटसाइड आरामनगर एंड जस्ट स्टैंड एंड सी पीपल माई एज और समबडी गुड लुकिंग enter a bungalow and I used to follow him and I used to enter that bungalow standing in line for hours just so that the casting director looks at me and just the so that I get a chance to perform and he notices me in some way or the other. Aise karke I gave my third, fourth, fifth audition. The sixth audition was my most favorite and my most treasured audition because it was the most funniest audition I've ever given in my life. I shall tell you what had happened. So I'd got a call saying ke yaar this is a shortlisted audition, so aap aa jao. Firstly, shortlisted audition is when they call only 5 or 7 people. So I was like, wow. So within his call, I reached in 15 minutes to him. I think he must have judged me, ki yaar ye to vela hi baitha hoga. So main aaya udhar, main room mein baitha aur maine dekha koi nahi tha udhar. So I thought, my space. I reached inside and he was sitting alone and I was like, sir, Ayush Mehra. And he was like, yeah, of course. So I was like, so script hai, professional, I try to act. And he said, ki nahi, I'll brief you, just go stand in front of the camera. I was like, okay. So he told me to give my name, number, profiles, which I'd learnt by now. And he told me, ke aap ke paas passport hai? To man mein laddu phuta. And I was like, of course, I have a passport. The shoot is abroad. So I was like, yes. Then he was like, do you know how to swim? Ek aur laddu phuta. I was like, yeah, of course, I know how to swim. So he's like, okay, when I say action, you start doing what I tell you, okay? So I was like, okay, yes, sir. So he's like, action. He was like, toh swim. Toh, maine bola, swim. So, yeah, swim. So then I started swimming. This is exactly how I was swimming. Then he's like, swim fast. And I started swimming fast. Then he's like, abhi tum thak rahe ho. Toh main thak gaya. फिर बोला जो एनर्जी ड्रिंक है ना वो आपके पास फ्लोट होके आ रहा है. तो फिर मैंने देखा वो ड्रिंक को फ्लोट होते आके अभी आप पी रहे हो, अभी एनर्जी आ गया आप में, अब आप वापस फास्ट करने लगे हो. देन ही सेड कट, वेरी गुड. आई वाज लाइक थैंक यू सर. ही इज लाइक यू स्विम रियली वेल या. एंड आई स्टेप आउट ऑफ द रूम एंड आई एम थिंकिंग टू माई सेल्फ, यार ये मैं क्या करके आया हूँ अंदर, हवे में स्विमिंग करके आया हूं मैं. सो बाय दिस टाइम आई हैड स्टार्टेड टू एंजॉय द प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑडिशनिंग एंड आई थॉट के यार आई एम प्रीटी डिटरमाइंड दैट आई विल फिनिश माय 10 ऑडिशंस एंड आई वाज लाइक इफ दिस हैज टू बी फॉर मी टू बी एन एक्टर देन फेयर इनफ, मैं कर लूंगा. तो 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th तक पहुंचते फॉर माई 10th एड ऑडिशन आई गॉट माई फर्स्ट एड. And I felt really, really happy that 10th audition mein meko mera pehla ad mil gaya. But getting that one ad means just getting that one ad. You know, for each ad audition, you have to face like 30 to 40 rejections. And everybody over here thinks an actor's life is parties, you know, cars, money, success, fame, love, which is true. But, which is true. But behind the success, there is so much struggle, which a lot of people don't know about. And the most common factor about that is rejection. And you know, everybody faces rejection over here. You know, it's very common being rejected from your parents, your family, your girlfriend, your job, everything. Everybody faces rejection. I remember my sister was sending CVs to apply for jobs, and she used to send one CV or two CV a week, and she used to get a sophisticated mail saying that you've been rejected. But for an actor, this is your CV. So you go to auditions and you're point blank on your face rejected, and it's not even your fault. Abhi mera face aisa hai, to abhi meri kya galti hai yaar? Like it's your family's or your genes ka fault yaar. So I was very lucky at that point of time to get rejected so many times that I became desensitized towards rejection, which was actually a good thing. And in deeper understanding of things, I started realizing that rejection is never your fault or it's never personal. Maybe you did not fit into that aspect at that point of time, but there are 10,000 other things where you might fit in. Or there might be 9,999 aspects where you might not fit in, but you just have to fit in that one aspect. So all you got to do is pick yourselves up, I know, be ziddi, and go for that take two. So this was my life lesson at that point of time from rejection. Now, obviously I was getting ads just sporadically somewhere here and there. And I was at that point, luckily, fortunate enough, not to only think about acting. I actually wanted to learn the craft of filmmaking. And I was like, yaar, agar acting nahi hona to main filmmaking, I want to know how the process of films, like what is the process of films and how are they made. So I got a job as an assistant director. So my first film, I was the clapper. So now, this is the clap from my first film. Film ka naam Gopal nahi tha. So here, you write the scene number, which scene is going on. You write the shot number over here, and you write the take number over here. And you have to say, scene one, shot one, take one. And the director shouts action from there. You must have seen this in film. It's a very nerve-wracking job. You always get yelled at, and you have to make sure you don't put the actor's nose in the middle. So this was my job. So my first film, my producer, who was very sweet enough to give me this opportunity, told me that in 2 weeks, since you want to be an actor, in 2 weeks, tell me why did I give you the clap. So I said, 2 weeks, why do you need Google? Hai na? Next day, I Googled it, and I knew the answer. And for 2 weeks, I chilled, I faffed, I made friends, maine aise khaya, mazay kiya, on set, not being aware of what is happening. Matlab, obviously being aware, you have to be aware of the clap. But after 2 weeks, he met me and he told me, ke, beta, why did I give you the clap? And I said, in very technical terms, that sir, this sync sound between the video and audio, and you know, the editor will see this and only then edit the film. So it's very important. And he looked at me and he said, you idiot. And I was like, he's like, I gave you the clap because you're closest to the actor when you're giving the clap. You're closest to the director when he's directing the actor. You understand lighting because you stand for the actor for lighting. You understand lensing because you're giving the clap in front of the camera. That's the reason why I gave you the clap. The name of my producer is Atul Agniotri, and I absolutely adore him to this date. Like, I love him and I feel he's the best producer in the world because he's taught me this so early on in my career that I kept focusing on the micro aspects in life. Like, I kept thinking about only being an actor, only focusing on my job, and I was missing the macro picture. And that's what we all do in life. We only focus on small things and not go for that bigger aspect of life. And this perspective has helped me so much that even when I get a scene right now in my career, I don't only look at my lines, I don't only look at my character now. I look at the overall scene, I look at the context of the scene, where it's fitting. And that's really helped me grow as an individual and as an actor. And I started becoming a team player because you don't only fend for yourself, you fend for the entire project. And I'm so glad he taught me that. Another AD story, AD teaches you a lot of things, yeah, in life. So AD matlab assisting, assistant director, okay? So when I was assisting, and this is the second story where we had to search for a location and we couldn't find any location. So, you know, it took us 10 days, 11 days, 12th day chal raha hai, location nahi mil rahi wo scene ke liye, everyone's dying, everyone's going here and there. 13th day we found a location and we are happy and we're like, yes, mil gayi location for this scene. It'll be so great that everyone will love it and we'll be just happy. And we reach on set the next day and the actor who's performing was atrocious and the whole scene fell flat. And at that point of time, I started deciding that I am not going to be this kind of an actor. I'm going to be an hardworking actor. So you see what happens here. When an actor is performing, you only see his performance, but there are 99 other things which are involved, which helps him do that performance and enhance his performance. So if you've not done your homework well, or if you've not prepared well, everybody's effort goes for waste. And at that point of time in my life, I don't know, from somewhere I started understanding empathy and hard work. And I feel that's my simple philosophy in life. Like, you have to work hard and you have to work hard every day. There are days when I feel like, chhodna yaar, kaun jayega gym, and oh, I do have to do this, why do I have to go for this audition? But then I follow my idols. Like, I have Cristiano Ronaldo and Virat Kohli as my idols. They are nowhere connected to acting, but they are my idols because I really like the way they push themselves, and that's how I look at things. And I feel everyone in life can achieve everything if you put in the right amount of hours, amount of effort, amount of work, amount of pain in it. That, you know, one pizza of that one party where you don't want to eat that pizza, that one night out where you don't want to go and work on yourself, that will slowly, slowly, slowly add up to the human being that you want to become and reach. And I truly, truly believe that. So now, after I finished assisting, I wanted to act now, seriously. And then I was 90 kilos. I was 90 kilos and I really wanted to lose weight. And now weight loss experts, though, there are everybody in this world. Like, everyone you ask his suggestions, give me a suggestion, how do I lose weight? Everyone will say, crash diet kar le, you might lose weight, do this, you might lose 10 kilos in a month, and this and that. And I knew that that's not the process I want to follow. Because I really feel that I am a person who breaks his goals down. So for me, I had to lose 24 kilos at that point of time. And so I decided, why not lose 2 kilos every month, and for a year, I will lose 24 kilos. That's a pretty simple calculation, you know. But nobody thinks of weight loss like that. I just had to control a little of my food and just focus a little on my workouts, and I would achieve that goal. And by the year end, I lost 25 kilos. So all I'm telling you to do is, I know everybody in life has a goal, and you know you have to reach that goal. Everybody has to reach goals in life, but there is no point stressing about a goal from here. You always have to break it down, go step by step, and you will reach there. Enjoy the process. And I feel that is so important for this generation, because we don't generally enjoy the process. We only want to reach the destination. And I can say that about myself, because tomorrow, if I become the world's biggest star, I hope I do, I will not get a chance to go to Aramnagar and audition like this. So this phase of my life is very important for me to reach there. If you reach directly in your destination, you won't savor it. So all I'm telling you to do is be in the moment, have a good time right now, because kal to karna hi hai wo bro. So there is no point stressing about it. This was it. This was my speech about the whole aspect of my TED talk. I don't know if I've been able to inspire anyone over here or not, but I remember when I got a call that, will you be able to give a TED talk? And I was with my girlfriend and I was like, should I give this TED talk? Yeah, we were going for dinner. And I was like, will I be able to inspire anyone, anywhere, even on YouTube? So she said, even if you don't inspire anyone, I'll be in the crowd cheering and clapping. So then, sold. There only. So I would thank her to inspire me, to inspire y'all. I hope I did. So thank you for listening, guys. Thank you for giving me a voice.